Hello friends, this is Dr. Arpana. I am a homeopathy consultant. I am practicing homeopathy. In this YouTube channel, I talk to you about the role and scope of homeopathy in the various diseased conditions and the homeopathic medicines as well. So today we will be discussing about the homeopathic medicine Camphora officinalis. So if you are new to my channel, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and of course hit on the bell icon so that you are always updated whenever I publish any new video, whenever I am sharing any information with you, you are the first one to receive it. So it is very important to subscribe to the channel and hit on the bell icon. So let's get started. Today we will be discussing about the homeopathic medicine Camphora officinalis. So Camphora officinalis, it's a homeopathic medicine. It is made up of camphor or also known as kapur. So in homeopathy, by the process of potentization, we can take out the medicinal properties from inert substances, and camphor is also one of them. So whenever we talk about any homeopathic medicines, we first of all must understand the drug picture. So the drug picture is like the personality of that medicine. So we all have different kind of personalities. So in the same way, we have so many different medicines, so many different drugs in our materia medica, and they all have a personality. That is the drug picture of the medicine. So whenever we prescribe any medicine to any patient, it is very important for us to understand the drug picture and the symptom presentation of the patient, and there should be matching between the two, and that is how the medicine is prescribed. So let us understand what is the drug picture of Camphora officinalis. So in the medicine Camphora, we see that there is extreme prostration, there is extreme weakness, and there is cold, clammy extremities. The patient is very much cold to touch, yet the patient would not like to cover himself. So there is cold extremities, coldness, the lips may be blue, there is kind of livid appearance, but there is aversion from covering. Along with that, we see that there is the surface is cold to touch, yet cannot bear to be covered. The patient will throw off the covering. The body is painfully sensitive to touch. The tongue is cold, flabby, and trembling. The pulse is weak and imperceptible. There is burning thirst for water. Camphora is a very good medicine after bad effects of surgery, injury, or even asphyxia. In Camphora, we can see that there is subsultus and trembling. So subsultus means there is a kind of tremor or twitching of the parts of the body, especially the arms or the limbs, and there is extreme restlessness. So the cold, clammy extremities, the restlessness, and one more important symptom of camphor is that the patient feels better when thinking about the complaints. So as soon as the patient is thinking about the complaint, as a general, the patient will feel better. Camphora is a very good medicine in case of Asiatic cholera, in case of influenza, especially the kind of influenza that we see during the change of the season. It's a very good medicine for cholera infantum, and it is a very good medicine for summer diarrhea as well. So let us now understand the symptoms of the different parts of the body. So first of all, in the head, so there will be a kind of vertigo. Vertigo will be present along with the catarrhal symptom. As I said, it's a very good medicine for influenza. So if there is influenza, there is coldness of the body, and there is vertigo. Along with that, we see that the nose is cold, pinched nose, tongue is cold and flabby, and there is fleeting stitches in the temporal region and in the orbits. In the eyes, there is a delusion that the patient is seeing some glittery flashes, and the pupils are dilated and the object feels too bright and glittering. Then coming to the symptoms of the nose is stopped, there is sneezing, there is coryza from the change of weather, and there is persistent epistaxis, that is bleeding from the nose. The face is anxious looking, the face is cold to touch, and there is sweating from the face. Now coming to the symptoms of the stool. So as I said, it is a very good medicine for cholera. So there will be watery stools. So the stools can be either watery like rice water, or it can be blackish in color. The stools are involuntary, as we see in case of Asiatic cholera, and along with that there will be cramps which is felt in the calves and coldness of the extremities. Coldness of the body is associated with great weakness of the body and the anguish of the mind. So now coming to the respiratory symptoms, there is precordial distress. Now what does this mean? So this means there is difficulty in breathing. It feels that the respiration is suspended and the patient needs some artificial support for breathing. So that is the kind of distress that we can see in case of camphora. It could be because of influenza, it could be because of some other reasons. So there is suspended respiration, there is dry hacking cough with cold breath. Now coming to the extremities, so in the extremities we see the cold, clammy extremities. There can be rheumatic pain, there is numbness, there is coldness, tingling, crackling of the joints and cramps which is felt in the calves. So we can also see the cramp in the calves with the diarrhea that the patient is having. It can be given in case of fever. Again, the fever will be associated with icy coldness of the whole body, burning thirst, and there is an aggravation from covering, or the patient would not like to cover even if the whole body is very, very cold to touch. So this is about the medicine Camphora officinalis. I hope you like the video, so do not forget to like, share, subscribe to the channel, and of course comment in the comment section. You can ask me your queries, I would try to reply to them. If you wish to book an appointment with me for any of your medical complaints, so all the details are given to you. You can send a message through WhatsApp in the given number and you will get the reply from my office. If you wish to speak to me over the phone, that too is possible with the help of an app. All the details are already given to you. So that is all for today. Have a nice and wonderful day. Thank you so much for watching.